Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to display data stored in your Google Sheets on your website. This technique allows you to easily update website content by simply editing the Google Sheet. So, you can assign someone to manage the data without giving them access to your website's admin area or having to contact developers every time you need to update details. To build this, we'll be using Google Apps Script and jQuery data tables, which come with features like search, sorting, and pagination. This allows users to find the information they need on your site quickly. We can divide this tutorial into two parts. In the first part, we'll create a JSON output for our Google Sheets data using Google Apps Script. Then, we'll use this JSON URL with the jQuery Data Tables plugin to create an interactive table that displays the data on the website. Let's start by preparing the Google Sheet. In your Google Sheets, make sure the first row contains the table headers. Avoid merging cells. While data tables can handle different data types, it's generally recommended to use consistent data types within each column. Go to Extensions and select Apps Script to open the script editor. Rename the project and change the function name to doGet. We'll start by creating a variable named sheet to hold a reference to the sheet 1 of the Google Sheets workbook where our data is stored. Next, we'll retrieve all the data from that sheet's range and store them in a variable called data. Now, let's log the data variable to check what it contains. Let's run the code. When running the code for the first time, it will ask for authorization to access your Google account. Click Review Permissions, choose your account, click Advanced, and then click the link with the name of the Apps Script project. Finally, click Allow. Once you've done that, you'll see part of the Google Sheets data displayed in the execution log, which means we've successfully retrieved the data from Google Sheets. Next, we need to convert this data into a JSON format. Create an empty object to hold the JSON data. The first row of the data variable contains the table headers, so we'll assign it to a new variable called headers. Let's log the headers variable to see what it contains. Let's create an empty property named data in the JSON data object. Next, loop through each row in the data variable. Create a new object named row to store the data from each row as key value pairs. Loop through each item in the headers array. Populate the row object with the header names as keys and the corresponding data as values. Finally, add the completed row object to the data property of the JSON data object. If you log the JSON data object, you'll see it contains the Google Sheets data as key value pairs. Next, let's return the JSON data as a response. First, we convert the JSON data object into a JSON string, which is the standard format for data exchange. Then, we create a text output object and set its content to the JSON string. Finally, we set the MIME type of the response to JSON, so the receiving application knows the data is in JSON format and can interpret it correctly. Now, let's deploy this code as a web app to get the JSON URL. First, click Deploy and select New Deployment. Choose Web App as the deployment type and add a description. In the Execute As field, select your email, and for who has access, choose anyone so that anyone with the URL can view the JSON data. Click Deploy, and then click the URL to see the JSON output. As you can see, the Google Sheets data has been successfully converted into JSON format. Now we've completed the first part by creating the JSON URL. Now, let's see how we can display this JSON data on our website. I'm going to use the jQuery Data Table plugin to create our table. First, go to datatables.net, navigate to Examples, then Ajax, and select the Ajax Data Source Objects option. We'll be using this example code. To demonstrate, I'll create a simple web page on my local machine. I'll start with a basic HTML structure. Let's customize it a bit. Copy the sample HTML code from the data table's website and paste it inside the body section. We won't be using the table footer, so let's remove it. I'm going to rename the table to Pizza Price. Next, update the table headers to match the ones in your Google Sheets. file as index.html. Now, we need to add the CSS and JavaScript libraries to our page. First, copy the link to the CSS library and add it to the header section using the link tag. Similarly, copy the links to the JavaScript libraries and include them at the bottom of the page using script tag. Copy the JavaScript code provided in the example and place it below the JavaScript libraries inside a script tag. Let's update the column headers to match ours. Make sure to type the exact same column headers used in your Google Sheet. Our table name is Pizza Price. For the Ajax URL, provide the JSON URL we created earlier. To get the URL, go to the App Script Editor, click Deploy, select Manage Deployments, and copy the URL from your final deployment. Replace the existing URL in the code with the one you just copied. Save the file. Now that we've completed the coding, let's open the index.html file in the browser. You'll see the Google Sheets data displayed in a clean, interactive table with several features. Users can search and filter data using the search box. By default, the table shows 10 records per page, but users can switch pages or adjust the number of entries per page using the dropdown. You can sort the data by clicking on the column headers. You can easily update the records by modifying the data in Google Sheets. I'll update the price of these two pizzas. Now, refresh the index.html page and search for the record we just updated. As you can see, the price has been updated successfully. Visit the blog post linked in the description to learn more and copy the code snippets shown in this video.